Hey Pirates, welcome back to another edition of Pirate News, Hispanic Heritage Edition.
Hammond here for Pirate News. I have a question. What is your favorite Hispanic dish?
My favorite Hispanic dish is caldo de pollo. It's like chicken soup.
That sounds delicioso.
All right, I'm here with
Jeremy.
Giselle.
And what's your guys' favorite Hispanic dish?
I like tamales.
Tinga.
Okay. I'm here with
Jaden.
And what's your favorite Hispanic dish?
Taco Bell.
All right, bro. Do your thing, bro.
I'm here with
Mr. Herrera.
Why is Hispanic Heritage Month important to you?
Hispanic Heritage Month, or Latino Heritage Month, I think it's important because it's a sense of identity. I think being Mexican-American is puts you in a position where you're not Mexican enough for being in Mexico, and you're not American enough for being in the U.S. So we have kind of like this loss of sense of identity, but then when we bring it back home, we realize that we all kind of come back to some sort of culture. And these dishes kind of go across all the way, you know, right? You know, a dish like a mole dish can be different in different parts of Mexico, speaking on being Mexican. But I just think it's a sense of identity and something we can always come back to. It's kind of just, it's home. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey Pirates, the In-N-Out truck comes today at lunch. Make sure you have your ticket, and remember, if you lost it or it got stolen, you will not be able to replace it.
Okay, I hear the dog still show at the Mexican Queen's Parade.
Hey Pirates, College Career Fair is Thursday, October 5th.
From 5:30 to 8:30, representatives from the University of California campuses will be there.
Seniors, panoramic pictures are Friday, September 29th, during 7th and 8th periods, so dress appropriately. Back to school night is Thursday, September 28th, from 6 to 7:50, so be there.
Hey Pirates, Hispanic Heritage Month continues at lunch on September 27th with Arts and Crafts. See y'all there.
Hi Pirates, for the Latin Heritage Month, let's learn through papel picado en español. El papel picado es papel perforado en forma de figuras. Es un arte tradicional que se puede encontrar en México y otras colonias españolas. El arte en papel es una mezcla de otras tradiciones artísticas, europeas, asiáticas y precolombinas. El papel fue inventado en China 105 años después de Cristo. La fabricación y corte de papel ya se había esparcido en Japón y Asia Central para el año 750. Los moros, quienes residieron en España desde el año 714 al 1492, intercambiaron con China y esparcieron las tradiciones de corte de papel basándose en imágenes geométricas según la ley islámica. Mientras la cultura islámica se esparcía en España, el corte de papel no se tardó en esparcirse en otras partes de Europa. Cuando España llegó a México, los aztecas ya tenían la tradición del corte de papel. Hacían papel machacando la pulpa de los árboles entre las rocas. Mientras el comercio entre naciones continuaba, el papel china usada para envolver porcelanas frágiles se extendió a Nuevo México, abriéndose paso en el arte popular. En Estados Unidos, el corte de papel se ha abierto camino principalmente en los círculos artísticos chicanos. Se han desarrollado muchas técnicas para crear obras maestras. Vamos a probarlo hoy.
Hey Pirates, student store hours for students, 7:50 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. and during lunch only. For parents and staff, please avoid going during school lunch.
Now let's check in with West Campus.
Hi everyone, here's what's happening at West. Let's meet our new assistant principal, Mr. DeVore.
Hello, I'm here with the new vice principal.
Hello, my name's Adam DeVore.
And this, I'm Justice Blackshear. And what's some of your background like? Where did you work previously?
Okay, so today is day 4, so I'm enjoying so far my time. Previously, I came from Los Padrinos Juvenile Hall here in Downey. And before that, I was an administrator and teacher in Pasadena Unified School District. And prior to that, I was with Los Angeles Unified School District. Was a teacher also there.
Okay, all right, how are you gonna make a difference at the school?
Okay, so at the school, I plan to make a difference. We're very unique school, right? We have 5 middle schools coming into 1 high school here. And so what I plan to do is help build relationships and to be visible with all the students. So I'm gonna be interactive and make sure that everyone has the best year possible and prepare everyone for 10th grade. That's my plan.
Okay, sweet.
During the month of September, our PHS West Spanish teachers would like to share some facts for Hispanic Heritage Month.
Buenos dias, everyone.
Buenos dias.
Welcome to class, Español. So we're going to get started. Remember, today, well, this month is National Hispanic Heritage Month. So remember, what was your homework?
Si.
So if you did, you should have facts about Spanish-speaking countries, right? Can you please take out your homework? Can one of you please raise your hand and share a fact about one of the Spanish-speaking countries?
You. Did you know that many Spanish words have Arabic roots, just like almohada and alfete?
Ah, so Arabic, that's a pretty good fact.
Did you know Ellen Ochoa was the first Hispanic woman to go to space?
Sarabia.
So I saw in Primer Impacto that the Chupacabras is back.
That Chupacabras. We can do better than that, mija. Okay. Over here.
Did you know that you could be friends with Bad Bunny on WhatsApp? I just saw that he went to the dentist yesterday.
Well, the good thing is that he went to the dentist. So. Over here.
Did you know that 21 countries have Spanish as their official language?
21 countries. That's good to know. Thank you for sharing your fact. That's how you met you.
Did you know that Hispanic Heritage Month starts on September 15th because 5 Central American countries celebrate their Independence Day?
Back.
Did you guys know that Mr. Alvarez loves Conchita so much, he sleeps with one under his pillow?
No, I don't.
Did you know over 400 million people in the world speak Spanish? It is the second most spoken language.
Did you know that Dolores Huerta coined the phrase, si se puede?
Oh, si se puede. Can we say si se puede? Si se puede! Nice. Adan.
You heard the Mexican government showing their minds of Aliens of Life TV, se me antoja una torta de jamón.
Ay, esas tortas. All right, enough of this nonsense. Let's get to work. Vamos a ponernos serios. Ready, guys?
Sí.
Yeah.
Yeah. ¡Saque su computadora!
And that concludes our news. And as always, keep it classy, West Campus.
Did you know?
You know, National Hispanic Heritage Month is celebrated from September 15th to October 15th. Now you know.
Now you know.
All right, folks, and welcome to Gladder Games. This week for Hispanic Heritage Month, we have a Latin dance competition. And here we have Eric, and we have Herrera, and we have two unknown students. And let's see what we got. 3, 2, 1, and they're off. And look at Eric. He's doing pretty good there. All right. And then we have the two unknown students, and I don't know what they're doing there. And they look all right. And let's see what's Herrera. He is pulling out the Macarena. I thought that was from the 80s, but apparently he's still got those moves here. And the winner is... No, not Herrera. That's ridiculous.
So two more problems. Let's go. It's ready. One, yeah. Broke her neck. Made you look.
You must be bored, mister.
I'ma get your back, mister.
Mister, I need help, please. Number 2. Wait, is that $5, mister?
Where? That's mine.
Broke your neck.
All right, so today we are adding more homework for tonight.
Shucks.
Thanks to Pancho.
Hey, Pirates.
That wraps up another edition of Pirate News.
See you next week.